Howdy folks, Phoenix here, and as you can tell from the thumbnail for this video, I'm going to show you how to build my A-frame cabin that I made for the starter kits back when I was on the edge of the world base on the old rag. So let's go ahead and get started. I figured this would be a fun little spot to build it right here in the Redwoods on Ragnarok. So let me go grab some foundations and we'll get started. Was approximately a 4x6, not counting the little dino storage in the back. Let's see if I picked a spot that'll give me enough room to work. Hopefully without any real major grass showing through. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This will probably work, but I think I want to change up the angle just so it fits a little bit better. So let's go here with this sort of an angle. Now maybe we can go a little tighter. Come up one more this way. Good, nothing floating. Alright, so that's 4 on the front. Six across the back. What is that? Okay, good. And then off the back side, I did put some foundations, but I sunk them down in just to make it look a little nicer. So let's go ahead and grab a couple of pillars so I can drop these. Nicely. Great. Yeah, let's start over. Put that one in, put that one in. Then we'll come here. And this is why most of my stuff you see will include a few extra materials. There. And then there. There. And just keep going back and forth until you get it to the height you want. One more time. Let's put those down. I think that'll be good. I'm good with that. I'm gonna sneak a few under here just for future purposes. You'll see when I get to it. Alright. Next step is going to be the first floor walls. I did put those in inside out. I'll show you how I did that. So let's go grab some walls, doors and windows, all that stuff. Put some of this junk away for now. Need some door frames. Some ceiling. Nope, not sloped roofs. Sorry. Regular ceilings. That'd be good. Handful of windows for now. And a bunch of walls. And that should get us started. Alright, so up front here, this is going to be a deck right here. So we can start with the door, followed by a wall. And to the left of the door, I did a window. And another wall. And to get that snap point, I look down at the tile I'm standing on. And then here we go, wall and a wall on either side, and I did a window in the center. Okay. Then as we come back further, I did two windows in the dining area, it looks like. Grab a window and a window. This side's all set. We'll pick all these up. Come back here, and this was a wall. I must get that one for a second. That was a door frame. This side, I did two more windows, and then I believe the rest were all walls, because this is your staircase, right behind this one. And a window, and a window. Alright, and then we'll just finish off with regular walls, rest of the way around. Not there though. Alright. And then we can start putting in our ceilings in here to get ready to do the second floor. Most of what you see me doing can be done on vanilla. There will be a few little knick-knacky tricks I do here that might not. I'm not 100% sure. Those are sloped again. I don't want sloped. I want regular ceilings. And then I need my staircase. And I'll just start with that for now. I need more ceilings than that though. Let's grab quite a few more. So the second floor here is going to extend all the way out to the end of the deck. Actually, we gotta take these two out. That's where our staircase needs to go. So let's pop that in now so we can get up there and work. Now onto the second floor. So the second floor, we still have, we're going right side this time with the doors or the walls and windows. Actually, I don't know if I get that on that side. Let me check. Let's start here. Sorry, not working as well as I wanted it to. So this one, I did a wall, a window, and a wall. And just checking my pictures. I believe I had that mirror imaged on both sides, wall, window, wall. And then as we get to, my apologies, that was the back side of the house. Let's do that over again, but up here on the front. It was wall, and then I have to put floors in here so I can get the snap point I want. Wall, window, and over here, wall, wall. Window. And in doing this, we end up with a different texture on the upper half of the house, just to kind of break things up a little bit, make it look a little different. And then in the back here, we do the opposing thing and we go with a window, wall, window setup. And then on the very back, I did a wall, window, and a door. Because there is a small back deck on this place. And the door sat here. This will be your hallway. Let me go ahead and get a little bit of gamma. It looks like we're starting to get into the nighttime here in the redwoods. Make sure we can still see. Let's grab a couple more walls and we'll wrap this second floor portion up. We'll also grab our greenhouse. Still got door frames, I'm good there. Grab a few more regular walls, a couple more windowed walls. Grab a few doors to put in place, and let's get back to it. Alright, up the stairs we go. So back to the back here, we need a wall. A wall. And then this one was a window. And then here again, we did wall, window, wall. So we need two more windows over here. And then we're gonna need walls here. I don't have the sloped ones yet, so we'll go back for those. And then the front here will be greenhouse windows and greenhouse slopes. And now now we should be able to go back. Get a few more materials here. We're gonna need the sloped roofs. Done with the ceilings. We're going to need to start getting some railings. Sloped walls. That should get us going for now. We'll get a little bit more built. Then I'll grab some, actually grab some ceilings back out and show you guys probably what I do with the, oh, no, I can't do the back deck yet. There's something else I gotta do first to be able to make it work. So we'll finish up out here first and then skip on over to the back deck. Start from the same side just in case, because sometimes with inside outs and not inside outs you get slightly different snap points on your sloped roofs. So if I start from the same side, usually my seams all line up pretty good. Now let's go ahead and slap those couple doors in that I have. And did I grab any? Yes, I did grab some railings. Let's put some railings in. I'm gonna try to hit that lower snap point. I'm sorry, that's not what I meant. I actually wanted to hit the upper snap point, like so, and not there. I did switch them to half walls before, but I don't think I'm gonna do that now. I think I'll leave them this way. And we don't actually need this one because that's gonna be the wall for the bedroom. So let's go ahead and hop down. We can come out here and put them in the deck area, like so. Alright, and then we can pop another door in right here. And now we could potentially work on some interior walls. So let's keep that for now. Let's grab some walls. I got plenty of door frames actually. Put the sloped roofs away, we're done with those. Grab these walls. Grab that. And we're gonna need one more stone pillar. Not an S plus one. Alright. So now we'll come back to the front of the house here. Pillars I have on the corners just to show a little support for that thing. And I actually probably don't have enough just because of the fact that the foundations are sitting a little higher than they were before. And apparently I cannot spell stone. See if I got enough mats to make two more. I do. Good. So now we can go. Okay. Down there. Alright. Looking good so far. So now let's come inside. And what I did for interior walls, etc. was this. Sorry, that was a door frame. It's supposed to be a door frame, I should say. No. So let's try that again. Get our door frame right there. That wall. And then we get a door frame right here, wall above it. And then I went this way to give the living room a little bit of extra space. And kind of create a little separation, living room, kitchen area, dining room, you know, that kind of stuff. Okay. So we'll grab a couple more doors, and we'll set up the bedroom upstairs and the bathroom. Good for door frames. Let's grab a few ramps. And I think that's all I'm gonna need. I'll grab a few more railings just in case, and I do need one sloped ceiling and a few of these. Alright, so let's get back at it. So the point of the sloped ceiling is for the back deck area here. I'll go ahead and show you how I did that now. So first I want that inside out texture. And I went up two squares. And then we snap our ceilings right there. This one is going to be a pain. That's all I can say. There it is. And there it is. And right here, we go up like this. I'm gonna have to snap one here just to get my slopes the way I want them. What we end up with right here is a nice little spot to park a super bear, or a dire bear, if you don't have what we have on this server. I even brought one with me to kind of show you what it's like. And then I'll show you what this other area is here in just a second. I'll actually include a, when I post a link on my Facebook, I'll include pictures of the interior so you guys can kind of see what it looks like. Because I don't have all the furnishings and I'm not gonna bore you guys with running around putting a bunch of little decorations in the house. But the little bear guy can go right here. The point of the sloped ceiling is to give you enough room to get off of him. And unfortunately, it's not going to work. You'll see in the pictures, I didn't build it on such an extreme slope when I built it. So, something to be mindful of. I could always go another half a wall higher. Let's go ahead and do that just so I can show you what it looks like when it's all said and done. But that being said, that's not how I originally built it. It wasn't intended to be a half wall higher. I didn't also intend on breaking a door frame up there. But either way, this is something I can do because we have S Plus. I can put that right there. And that one right there. And before I do that, I should put a wall actually down here. So this snaps down below like it's supposed to. And then because they're S Plus, we can do this. And then I can put these back in. Put my sloped ceiling back in. And create my bear garage. And now that That should give me the room I need to be able to back the bear in here. And still get off. I have to duck. That's just kind of how it goes. You duck, you can slide off the bear. And there you go, a little bit of bear parking. Bears, whether they're super bears or not, make pretty good all-around haulers and whatnot. So, it's kind of why that's my dino of choice to put up there. And I just finished that off there. Back here is just a little crafting area. That's kind of what I utilize this spot for. You can see it in the pictures that I, how I do it and everything. Also, switching those to stairs is an S+ feature. Not something that everyone's going to be able to do. Let's go ahead and get the bedroom and the bathroom set up now. So just to kind of try to keep with the inside out theme, I'm going to try to make it where this, a little bit of lag there, where this snaps to the lower one right there. The lower one right here, I do, but it's facing the other way. Okay. Let me check my pictures and see if I can figure out how I did this. I see. So, what I did was, down here, I gave this whole room the inside out texture. And that way the entirety of the kitchen was the other texture. Let's go ahead and fix that. And then that should fix my snap point issues upstairs. So now if I come up here, I should get the proper snap point for this. Probably take me a few goes at it, but eventually it'll go where I want. And then this one will be easy. This is going to be the door into the bedroom. But then those two, I'm going to have to come down here. And for the moment, sorry about that, folks. Phone call. Can't help when people call, but see. So I come down here, and this is what I gotta do to get it to work upstairs, except for, I believe they have to be on this side. And then I should be able to come up here then. Get walls in here that line up with these walls. And then I can take these back out and start finishing off the walls up here. Get a couple slopes in. Try the other one. And then we'll go for this side here. Okay, so as you can see, I had to put the ceilings underneath again to get the lower snap point, and it just gets a little finicky is all. Keep trying, eventually you'll get it. There we go, and then the door is right here. Upper piece in, and I'm gonna have to go down there and steel a wall to finish this off. Alright, one more right here, one sloped wall, and then the only other thing that I need be in here. Need a couple of these and those. Alright. Oh, I forgot my railings back there. One other thing I did was put a couple railings out and around this little spot right here. Which also can't be, just in the little S plus trick. Vanilla railings won't do that right there. But I put a railing at there, there. And I usually snap a ceiling in and put one on the end, but either way. And it's a little crowded, but your Tapajara or Pterodon will perch right here. So you can store one of your birds up there. So then you come in the bathroom here. And it does not cooperate. No surprise there. Let's try this again. Put the greenhouse stuff in right here. Like so. And this creates your shower. Doors, and we're going to need a wall because we broke a wall. We're done with that, we're done with that. We're going to need to make one more door. Don't have greenhouse windows, so we're actually going to have to make a quick trip to my base. Let's grab this little birdie bird. We're going to just teleport it for speed. Okay, let's head down here. Make a couple quick greenhouse windows. I don't know what happened to them because I'm pretty sure I crafted them all, but I usually make about 15. I don't always use all 15, but usually make 15. Like I said, if you want to see it decorated, I do have pictures of that that I will post on my Facebook with the link to the video. And the link to my Facebook will be in the description of the video, so you can pop over there if you want to see what it looks like with the interior. I'll kind of explain to you what I did in each room, at least. And, you know, you can choose to do it from there based on whether you're on PC or not and what kind of mods you have access to. This is my base, by the way. I'll probably give you guys a little tour of this in one of these upcoming videos. Oh, that wasn't very good. I didn't want to teleport to feet. Let's try that again. I want to go back to here. This will take me pretty close to where I was building. We can fly in, get a little bit of an aerial shot of the house. I'll pop the windows in, you guys can kind of see what the finished product looks like, and then I'll walk you through how I decorated it. And then if you guys want to, you can pop over to my Facebook to see the screenshots of the decorated version. But I built the house right up here on the cliff. Let's elevate ourselves to get a better aerial shot of it. There it is. Just a simple little A-frame cabin. When you look at the pictures of the decorated version, there is, you know, ample storage. So if you wanted to use it as a basic base, you could. It just doesn't include a lot of good dino storage or safe dino storage for that matter. But either way, functions as a good starter location, safe house for you to be in, you know, all that kind of stuff. Let's pop these windows in. So you guys can get a feel for the finished product. One for the bathroom sink area, one to let out the heat from the shower. A couple around here. Front of the house, a couple in the kitchen, a couple in the dining area. So we used 13 of them. Okay, so basically, when I had this house built, you'd walk in and this would be a living room, you know, a little couch, and I popped the fireplace right in the corner, put a nice war map up here and some mounts of dinosaurs, which I can do because we have mods with that, You know, you just maybe you can put your trophies from defeating the bosses and things of that nature up. This would be my little kitchen cooking area. I had a cooker right here and a couple of ice boxes, preserving bins, whatever you use based on your, like I said, your mods or what version you're playing. You can put storage boxes here and here to utilize that as some basic storage. This was my dining area. I had my table and a light hanging down. And then when you go upstairs, this was just the loft area. I had a desk, which was one of my crafting stations for the mods. Put a piano in here because one of the mods had a piano. It just another loft area. You could utilize it as a resource type space if you wanted. If you wanted to make this more like a crafting and creation area, it's up to you. This I utilized as a bedroom. You could line this side with storage boxes to hold all your armor and whatnot. And I put a few beds in here, nicely spaced, looked real nice. And this was just a bathroom, just for decoration. I had a shower sitting in here, and toilet was sitting right here, and then the sink was right there. Just basic bathroom. And you come out to the back deck, got your bird. Nice front deck, nice view off the front deck. And then I put my forge and my smithy and all that right here. So that is my basic A-frame cabin build. Hope you guys like it. Feel free to comment on it. Let me know what you think. I appreciate the comments. And thanks for tuning in. I'll see y'all later.